After a meeting this morning with the Clark County Sheriff's Department, and after having spent a solemn evening with the Sheriff of Clark County, effective immediately, Clark County Sheriff Dan Rodden will be placed upon a leave of absence, an administrative leave of absence, until further notice. This comes after less than 24 hours ago, the Sheriff of Clark County being charged with making false statements to the federal government in an FBI investigation, and after having been alleged to have engaged in conduct wherein he is accused of counseling someone to destroy evidence involved in a federal criminal investigation. In addition, the new head of the Clark County Sheriff's Department during the Sheriff Rodden's absence will be Chief John K. Hafer. John's been a sheriff's employee for nearly 36 years. He spent 8 years as a patrolman, 18 years as the chief of detectives or a detective. In the past 7 years, he has been Sheriff Rodden's chief. We're hopeful, and the department is hopeful, that everyone will in the community will join the men and women who comprise the Sheriff's Department in making sure that we are capable of moving forward. There's assurance that the services of the Sheriff's Department will not be affected by these events, and certainly expect that the quality and level of commitment of the men and women of the department will not change. And I guess that's pretty much what I had to say. If you got any questions, I'll answer a few if I can. Well, I think that in any matter such as this, we're less than 24 hours away from this indictment, and certainly I wouldn't foreclose this as being something that's a moving target, and that things will not go forward and advance in different ways as this matter moves forward. Sheriff's going to be the sheriff for the next 5 months, and certainly we are at a point where we are not certain as to what the discovery will indicate. The federal government has alleged and the basis for their allegations. And again, I mean, it's less than 24 hours ago the sheriff was taken into custody and arraigned. So this is the most prudent thing to do at this time, is to immediately react in a manner that's not an overreaction, and to ensure that the ongoing operation of the Sheriff's Department continues and is taken up by someone with experience, who is certainly Chief K. Hafer, and this certainly gives it was the sheriff's decision and choice to step away in order to make sure that the citizens and residents of the community understood that he takes this matter serious, the allegations are serious, and that he certainly wants to make sure that there's no additional damage to the community's impressions of that department.
Larry, was this his decision to take the leave, or was he asked to do it?
No, absolutely. It was Danny's decision, and it was a decision that came after a great deal of deliberation and discussions about all the options, and he was counseled that this was the most prudent option at the time. And I think that his immediate feelings about what the steps that he should undertake were probably directed more by his lawyers than he cared. And certainly as lawyers, that's our job, and our job is to make sure that our clients don't overreact and they don't do things that in the end of the day aren't timed correctly. And certainly, you know, I'll say this, and I've said it time again, and I'll always say it. Danny Rodden was my friend yesterday, and he's my friend today, and he was my friend the day before this happened. And if you know him like we know him, you know, Danny wants to do the right thing, and it's very difficult for someone to listen to folks who have jobs that require that they counsel their clients to do the things that are necessary and prudent into the circumstances. And he'll continue to do that, and it'll be done in a method and a manner that is necessary for this case to go forward in a fashion that will result in the best result for everyone involved.
Paid or unpaid?
And actually, the reality is you can't make yourself unpaid if you're an elected official. That was something we had to look at to decide what the effect would be. And again, there's a reason why I had to find that out, because that was something that was important. And I will say to you that the only reason that it has to be the way it is because the law allows it to be no other way.
Is his defense going to be paid for by the county, or is he on his own to pay for it?
His defense is paid for by himself. That would be a violation of the attorney-client privilege, which I hold dearly to my heart, so I can't discuss that. That is correct. After he was transported to Indianapolis from Clark County, I proceeded to go to Indianapolis, and we took care of our court business, and then we drove back together. Yeah, Danny's very disappointed in himself, very concerned about what effect these allegations will have on the community and his family. And, you know, if you know Danny, you understand that this is tearing at him, and he was just very distraught about what has happened, and certainly wants to do everything that's right and everything that is right for the community and everything that's right for his family and everything that is right that is what he believes in his heart should be done to make things right.
Has he spoken with or met with the staff?
Chief Kay Hafer had an opportunity to meet at length with Sheriff Rodden when the decision was formulated that this would be how we would go forward, and they had a substantial opportunity to discuss the process. And as I said this morning before I came here, the discussion was had in the sheriff's office as to, at 10:01, the head of the department for the sheriff of Clark County would be John K. Heffer.
Which of the charges are the most serious? Because in some of these cases, you understand that you're in a bit more trouble if you're accused of lying to authorities than you are for the questions that brought the authorities to your door in the first place.
Well, and all of the charges are serious. And it's a very serious set of allegations. And I think that it's intuitive for you to ask that question, because I think we're all aware of the fact that people serve time in prison in Watergate, not for breaking into a building, but for being dishonest with the federal government. That Martha Stewart spent time in prison, not for insider trading, but for being dishonest with the federal government. So I think that the issue of the true set of allegations is certainly not what's important. What is important is the misrepresentation, if in fact that occurred, to the federal government as to the truthfulness of the questions asked. That would be a question you'd have to ask Joe Hogsett, and I bet he would answer.
Did you know he's part of the bigger investigation?
To my knowledge, there's no bigger investigation. That this is, in fact, what occurred yesterday was the culmination of an investigation. I don't have knowledge of whether or not that's accurate or true, but I think that certainly a review of the facts of what occurred in Boone County would be something that you could look at and come away with your own conclusions. I haven't seen an individual's name in either one of those cases, so without knowing what the name is of that individual, I couldn't answer that. I don't think that's a fair question, because we really don't know what and where we are right now. I mean, again, there's a lot of questions that you all have asked. There's a lot of questions that remain unanswered that require time to determine what they are. The question of, can an elected official take a leave of absence and not be paid? That's something that was a legal question that had to find an answer. You're talking about benefits that haven't even considered that part of it, but sure, that's something that has to be taken into consideration. And as lawyers, our job is to move forward. And despite sometimes what our clients' desires are and what our clients believe they should do, we must counsel them at what is most prudent and best for their situation and circumstances at the time. And this is a decision that was crafted after a lot of discussion about what Danny wanted to do and felt he needed to do, and what, as lawyers, we needed to make sure happened in an order and in a fashion that it needed to happen. That'd be a question somebody might have to ask, and an answer that certainly he would provide, I'm sure. Again, that answer kind of rests in the whole of what does all of this mean, and we need to figure out legally where we are.
If the sheriff were to resign before the end of this term, how would it impact his pension and retirement?
You know, that's a good question, and I don't know the answer, but that's certainly something we're trying to find out.
Did he want to resign and you stopped him?
That would mean that I would have to tell you what my advice to a client was, and I don't want to breach that privilege.
How much of a heads up was he able to give county officials, or was he able to give?
None.
Did he suspect the indictment was
coming? Not at all. When he was transported, his telephone was immediately taken from him. He was immediately taken to Indianapolis, and in fact, I was notified of my necessity to make a trip to Indianapolis by someone other than the sheriff himself.
Where was he arrested?
In Clark County, in the courthouse. In the sheriff's office. When, and what, at what time? What time frame? I don't know any conversation that Sheriff Rodden has had with any of the other individuals that are employed at the Sheriff's Department. I know John K. Hafer is in charge, and certainly those are questions that probably Chief K. Hafer could answer.
Okay.